Not long ago, I got in an argument on Twitter about whether the International Space Station is in space or in the atmosphere. I mean, it's called the International Space Station, so of course it's in space, right? Maybe it's not. It seems like a simple question. Space starts at 100 kilometers. That's called the Kármán line, the Fédération Aéronautique Internationale's demarcation of where space begins. Then I reached out to NASA and they confirmed it. Yes, internationally, the Kármán line means space. Everything above space, everything below, not space. The ISS is above, so it's in space. But my Twitter fighter was also right. See, the Kármán line actually still is in the atmosphere, in the thermosphere, actually. See, NASA spokesperson Dan Hewitt told me from a physical sciences perspective, quote, "There is no hard definable point where space begins. The atmosphere just gradually decreases the higher you get. So where does space actually start? We are at the bottom of Earth's atmosphere here in the troposphere. This is where regular clouds appear, where weather happens, Mount Everest is there, everything you hang out with. The troposphere contains about 75 to 80% of all the atoms that make up our blanket of air. Above that, practically speaking, there are three more layers of atmosphere, the stratosphere, mesosphere, and thermosphere. The stratosphere is where the ozone layer is, where planes fly, and where we sent that 360 camera on a weather balloon last year that won us a Webby. It's awesome. At the top of that layer, around 50 kilometers, the pressure is less than 1% of ground level. You're above more than 99% of the atmosphere, and we're still only at the top of layer two. We're still hundreds of miles from the International Space Station. The mesosphere is next. This is where meteors burn up. They're moving ridiculously fast. So even though there's almost no actual air in this layer, they still hit a lot of molecules in a short time. But there's still the thermosphere, where X-rays and UV are absorbed and where aurora manifest. The air here is actually hot, but there's so little of it, you'd feel cold. Molecules of air so rarely meet, and when they do, they naturally sort themselves by type. Even though we're calling this the atmosphere, there's not much atmo at all. The thermosphere extends hundreds and hundreds of miles up above the Earth. And this is why the argument started. Because the space shuttle, International Space Station, and some low orbit satellites do fly in the thermosphere. But they're in a near vacuum and above the Kármán line. There's almost no air at all. Less than 0.001% of the atmosphere exists there. And yet, we're not done. There's a whole other layer called the exosphere. Even though the thermosphere is a vacuum, it's definitely space. The exosphere is considered an atmospheric layer by NASA and some scientists. Basically, that's because it's where the sun's rays overpower Earth's gravity and move particles around. But it is huge, extending 190,000 kilometers out into space. That's halfway to the moon. On top of that, when the Earth is between the moon and the sun, the solar wind pushes particles from our atmosphere all the way to the lunar surface along a tail called the plasma sheet. Bits of Earth's atmosphere can be thrown so far that they show up on the moon. It's pretty intense. Okay, so to wrap it up, in nature, things are not binary. Where does the ocean end at the beach, right? The beach is a gradient. The water goes back and forth. There are tides and weather, lots of influencing factors. So where does our atmosphere end? Not sure. Question of where space begins, though, the Kármán line, 100 kilometers. Why? Because it had to start somewhere. This episode is sponsored by Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, make your next move with Squarespace. Squarespace is used by a wide range of people, creatives, musicians, designers, artists, restaurants, and more. Start your free trial today at squarespace.com and enter offer code SEEKER to get 10% off your first purchase. Space is a part of nature, which means it's complicated and doesn't always fit into clean little boxes. We have to tweak it. For example, do you know what space actually looks like? Because chances are you don't. Space pics are usually fake. Find out more with Amy here. Have you ever Twitter fought with somebody? How about lately? Any good science ideas in those fights? Let us know down in the comments or on Twitter. I'm @TraceDominguez. And take a second and please subscribe.